starts out with a bank robbery. Okay, the whole point is there's a giant crocodile, right? It starts out with a bank robbery. The bank robbers all walk into the airport with a disguise. They're all wearing leather trench coats and leather jackets. They have shades on. They're all like
that's their disguise.
I was like, this is the most suspicious thing in the world. I was like, this is the worst.
You'd be detained.
I was like, this is. No.
I'm pretty sure they'd tell you no.
Yeah, it's
don't
bad.
Come here. Get out of my bank.
But clearly the airport's incompetent because they managed to sneak like guns on the plane. I'm just like, oh my god.
When did this movie come out?
This is probably in the 90s, I think.
That would explain why, yeah.
But I can't say for sure.
All right.
I'll be too slow on the phone.
You know what? I'm going to go because I have to clean Uma's controller.
All right.
Figure out what other services I need to provide. Controller-related services. So I'm gonna leave the stream in your capable hands. as I came to it.
Capable, yes.
capable hands.
That is the word I would use, yes.
All right, cool.
Capable.
All right, see you guys in the stream. Right. Have a good night. You're watching SG. Peace. Stay tuned for, what is this? Loser Semis?
Yeah.
Stay tuned for Loser Semis.
Aw, oh, man, I have to keep switching the player names. This is a doozy, this is. I think the thing about Snake that people dislike is that some of his things are kind of, like, counterintuitive. Like, just, like, the whole, like, sticking through a shield thing. That's always come off particularly weird to me. But, like, I don't know. I don't think it's anything to, like, be like, oh, this character is broken because of it. It's just, like, it's its own kind of niche thing. I guess, I think that's what throws people off, but personally, I don't care about it. Nice, that was the mumbo jumbo edge guard there. See, my commentary is like getting significantly worse now that I have nobody to work off of. Oh no. Alright, here's my analytical commentary. They're both wearing red skins in the game. That's all of my analytical commentary. That's all I can provide. It's not too often you see Link anymore, though. I mean, when SoL used to be around more, then it was like, okay, but... I don't know. Link's a cool character. Well, I feel like that's a really generic thing to say. That's kind of the problem with PM. You're like, ah, that's a cool character, but it's like, oh, right, there's the rest of the roster, and that's also cool characters. Oh man, chat is getting suspicious. You guys need to calm down. Much like when Snake dies in the video game, and they're like, "Ah, man, Snake, are you there?" And it's like, it's too late, he's dead. The crowd cheered too late for Snake because he had already won. It's like, oh man, that's a little bit later there than maybe Showtime. What you gotta do. Go! That was an interesting interaction. I wish I could say what happened there, but you know, it was interesting. they did move. Make any definitive statements here because I really don't have a clue as to what stage Link likes or what stage Soul likes in particular. But my guess regarding this stage is it's just probably to make it easier to kill Snake off the side to have to edgeguard. That's my guess. It could be accurate, it could be the least accurate thing in the world. I don't really know. But I'm trying to think of other reasons. Maybe it could be anything with the actual stage, but it couldn't be in terms of recovery in any other aspect, I don't think. Because Link's not going to recover from way down, and Snake will. So I don't think it would have to do with that. I feel like that would be almost kind of Snake's move. But it could be for edge guarding, it could be for platform placement. Could be a comfort thing. I don't know. I'm just gonna leave those theories out there. Just never gonna find out the answer. And then maybe in like 30 years, Unsolved Mysteries will come back and they'll do an episode on it. I was worried about that. That was good. Just unfortunate. Would still probably be better than it is right now. Alright. It's getting to... Well, I don't know. I don't know what I was about to say.
Three, two, it's showtime. One, go!
Okay, so...
No...
Okay, so again, Soul's choice, a stage with smaller stage with closer blast zones on the side is the phrase I'm looking for. From my perspective of not knowing a single thing ever, I do think it's... Maybe a good choice. If he's looking for the same stage, I would say the same kind of stage, I would say yes. Just because well, he's got a wall jump, I think. He must, yeah. So at least here if Soul gets too low, maybe he can get himself covered a little bit more often than found where you can't really do that place. But yeah, he's still got the, he doesn't get the three platforms, but shorter stage, less horizontal, you know. Did I say vertical earlier instead of horizontal? Oh, me, oh my. Did I say either of those words earlier? This is working a bit more swimmingly for Soul. Go away. Go away. Go away. rolled right into that line. So it seems like with the with the lead he had, he still has technically. I mean, I don't know what his strategy is, but my guess would be kind of try to lure Brimley into the reptiles and just like he's maybe going for it, possibly. I don't know. I don't like to try to guess what players are doing. It's like, I don't know, like, these people are smart, I'm not, like, I don't know what I'm supposed to say. I feel like there should be more top player commentary near the end of tournaments and all, but at this point they want to play friendlies, and I feel like it'd be better if newer commentators, or just worse commentators like me, commentated at the start of the bracket when there's less, maybe less serious matches, or like less, how do I want to put it? Not less serious, it's still serious, but like less technical, that kind of stuff. A lot of times. I think, like, that would be a better time, but a lot of times it's the top players commentating at the start because they have buys, and the other people have to play, and so they're not commentating. And then the top players later want to play friendlies, understandably, because they haven't done so yet. So that's why you get stuck with hooligans like me on the mic for loser semis instead of somebody with brains. As a joke for the record, I actually do have brains, to most people's surprise. They're just kind of rotted away. Alright. So, it's going to be Brimley's pick, because that's the way it is. So if SoL wants to win the set, he's got to beat Brimley on two of Brimley's stage choices here. Probably going to be a little tricky. Probably. All right, Smashville. Three, two, I'm not going to count the game because I'm lazy. Also, I haven't checked that camera, so I don't know if it works. And I'm not going to skip out mid-match to a camera that isn't working. Looks like, at least compared to earlier, from what I've noticed, looks like SoL's getting more cautious now. Which, smart, yeah. Not to say being aggressive is smart, but I mean, he has to beat two. Well, Brimley has to win one game, SoL has to win two. So it's like, man, you can't afford to make any risky mistakes here. I feel like I'm talking in circles, but I don't really know what I'm saying. I'm just saying, very good. I should have bought a coffee. Back air. Unshielded back air. Alright. Evens it right back up. That was cool. A little bomb dance. That's not what it was. That's not even an accurate description. A dance? Nah. This is cool. Alright. I missed the chance to tell Everfresh about the Scumbum. There's this, Smokey and the Bandit. I forget what the sheriff's original insult was. It says something like shitbird or shithead. And they used to censor it for TV. And they just really poorly dubbed it over. So it was like, you. And then it's a completely different voice. Scumbum. I was just like, Scumbum. Oh my god, that's the best insult of all time. In the whole everywhere. Like, no one's ever come up with something better than that. I should have mentioned that when Everfresh was being critiqued for his swearing. Super spooky swearing. Did he even swear? He swore at least once. Yeah, he swore like once. But like, it's not as much as I did. I don't know why. Cat, are you still here? You, Marmalade, Maestro. Yes, you are. I don't know why you were even ever fresh. The old pointy finger when I'm around. All right, there's a game going on, isn't there? So he's got a decent game, but it's tricky because if he loses the stock, he loses the game. And the bracket. Don't want that. Game. All right. So.
The winner is...
Moving on to the last game of the set here. It's going to be extra pressure. We'll see if that impacts anything. Any flubs or anything. We'll see. I might not see. But, you know, someone out there will be like, oh, yeah, that's a thing. That's pretty good. I've used the joke too many times for it to be funny anymore, but I like SoL's tag is good for puns. Like, you can be like, ah, he's looking to become the SoL winner of the set. It's like, it's pretty bad. But if you're lucky, it'll loop around and then it becomes good. So, Brimley's pick. This is basically, to me, in my humble opinion, the opposite of what SoL is typically choosing for his choice in terms of stage. Because SoL is like, oh yeah, Fountain of Dreams, Smash Bros. Like, alright, makes sense. Smaller stages. And this is El Grande Turbo Large stage, you know? It's like, So, I'm a bit surprised that SoL didn't ban it, but he has his reasons. But I wouldn't think this would be, I don't know. I think it's kind of tricky just because the blast zones are so huge, and Snake just like, they just kind of meandered on back. Oh. If you don't edgeguard him. And edgeguarding him could be a trick hit there. So I feel like this is, I think it's difficult, but I mean, they're keeping it even. But then again, no one's taking the stock yet, so. And that's really where it comes into play. Everyone's at high percentages there. Everyone. Everyone, as in the whole two people on the screen. Yes, I am the intelligent. Interesting kind of prods here. I don't want to call them pokes. I'm going to call them prods. Fun facts, both these characters use explosives, and not only that, the similarities continue. That was unfortunate. Similarities continue. Link is basically a silent protagonist. If you mute the TV, then he's 100% a silent protagonist. And if you mute the TV when playing Metal Gear Solid, Snake also won't make noise. So he's also a silent protagonist. So that's pretty good. It's like that adds a little more depth to the matchup. There was that one word that I never really understood. I think it was meant to replace like swag, swerve, or whatever. And that word was swole. I actually have no idea what that means. But soul, swole, like I feel like you could do something funny there, probably. Just came to mind. Oh, okay. So SoL is swole. I see. Okay. It could be Flarp. I think there's deeper meaning to SoL's arrows that he's shooting. I'm not gonna kill the Brimley. But see, what's an arrow? It's a projectile. But not only is it a projectile, an arrow is used to point. So not only is he like, alright, I'm gonna smack you up, he's also saying, I'm pointing you off the stage. Unfortunately, it didn't work because Brimley won.
The winner is
unfortunately for SoL anyways, it's fortunately for Brimley. But I think next time SoL is guaranteed to win if he uses the SoL is swole as some sort of chant or something. I feel like that would bring a lot to the table.